Welcome to my class. This week we're going to work on some poses that allow us to open up our hips, to bring a little more mobility into this area, and just to relieve any tension that we may be carrying. And as always, only do what works best for you. I will modify each pose and just have fun. So let's go ahead and start off seated as we always do, legs crossed or extended, whatever works best. Roll your shoulders back and away from your ears. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath in through the nostrils. Exhale out the mouth. Two more times. Continue breathing in and out through your nostrils, but slowing it down as you bring awareness to any parts of your body where you feel tightness, where you feel resistance, and just let it go. Making sure to lengthen through the crown of your head. Just a little more each time. Rolling the shoulders away from the ears with each exhale. Sound of your breath. Today is a rainy day, so I'm also focusing on the sounds of the water as it drops. It's a nice, relaxing sound. Thoughts arise, just acknowledge those thoughts and brush them aside. Come back to the sound of your breath. One more inhale. Inhale, take a deep inhale, and exhale, drop your ear to the shoulder, feeling a stretch along the opposite side of your neck. On your knees, you can place one hand on the ground and the other one behind you. So I started off with my right ear on my right shoulder, right hand is on the ground, left hand is behind me. One more breath. I'm going to inhale back to center and do the same thing on the other side, on the exhale. Inhale back to center. And let's go ahead and widen the legs like the letter V. We go straight into opening up our hips. just shimmying your legs as wide as you can. Keeping the feet active, so the toes are pointing towards your body, legs are engaged. I'm already feeling tightness in my inner thighs, so that alone is opening up the hip. So you can stay here, or you can keep your spine straight, place your hands at center, and walk the hands until you find your edge. Use your breath. Use your exhales to guide you. Feel the tightness. Let it go with the exhales. Let's go a little deeper. So we inhale, exhale. Walk the hands up a centimeter or two, an inch or two, wherever you feel is best. Remember to keep the feet engaged, keeping them flexed. You can stay here for five more breaths. Go ahead, take an inhale, and even go a little further. Perhaps your elbow touches the ground, your forearms are flat on the ground. Whatever works best. Just make sure you use your exhales to guide you. When you're done, inhale back to center using your hands. Slowly bring the feet together, creating a diamond shape. Back is straight, chest is lifted, hands at the ankles. Heels can be wide and away from the hips, or you can bring them nice and close, or bring them right in the middle. So take a deep inhale, exhale, fold forward. Let the elbows press the knees down as you actively press the feet together. You can stay here for five more breaths, or you can come back to center, bring the heels a little closer, and exhale down. One more breath. Inhale, come back. And then let's go ahead and shake it out. Legs extended. Let's bring our right ankle on top and place it on top of the left knee. You're gonna grab your foot with your left hand and just rotate the ankle. Right hand can stay on the shin. You can place it on your knee and just gently apply pressure. Still opening up the hips. do this for 5 more breaths, or you can fold forward, placing your elbow on your knee, applying a little more pressure. Stay here for 5 more breaths, or gently fold forward, place your elbow on your knee, continue to rotate the ankle, or stay in stillness. Back to center. Shake it out once again. Let's go ahead and do some seated forward folds just to give our hamstrings a little stretch. So imagine a body shaped like the letter L. Feet are flexed, legs engaged, hands come to the side. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half rise. Exhale, fold. Going as far as your hands allow. You can grab your toes or keep your hands at your ankles or on your shins. But just make sure you're actively pulling yourself closer to your butt. Excuse me, to your legs. Keep warming up the hamstrings while we open up the hip, keeping that knee as close to the ground as possible, and then just shifting our alignment towards the extended leg. So we're going to keep that left hand on our knee, inhale the right arm, and exhale, fold. So your hand can stay on the ground as you keep the knee down with your forearm, or you can place it on your knee, whatever works best. Inhale, come back to center. Switch sides. Right hand on the knee or on the ground with your forearm pressing the knee down. Inhale the left arm up, exhale fold. Inhale, come back to center. Let's go ahead and come onto our backs. Pause for a moment. Take a few breaths here as you allow your back to be supported by the ground beneath you. We're going to windshield wipe the knees side to side. Exhaling, dropping them over to the left. Inhaling to center, dropping them to the right. Going at your own pace with your own breath. You can even pause on each side for a few breaths. Whatever works best for you. Just listen to your body and give it what it needs. Done, come back to center and extend the legs. We're going to hug in the right knee into the chest. Left leg stays extended, feet are flexed. You can let the left heel rest on the ground, or you can let it float an inch or two off the ground. Make sure you're actively pulling that knee into your chest. We're gonna inhale. Exhale, drop the knee to the left side. Coming into a very gentle twist. No need to force anything, no need to deepen anything, just allow gravity to gently open up any spaces, create a little more movement, a little more mobility. Inhale back to center. And this time, keep that knee into the chest. And then instead of bringing it back down, we're going to extend it. We're going to drop it over to the right side. So the foot is going to be on the ground. Naturally, the knee is going to want to come up. That's okay. Just gently apply pressure as you open up the hip. When you're ready, come back to center, make circles. Inhale, the left knee into the chest, hug it in, keep the feet flexed, right heel on the ground or off the ground. deep breaths. And allowing gravity to create space. And just drop it over to the left side, letting the left foot rest on the ground and gently applying pressure onto that left knee with your left hand. When you're ready. Pausing for a moment. We're going to go ahead. Bend the knees. We're going to place our right ankle top of our left knee, left leg comes up 90 degrees, interlace the fingers behind the left thigh, keep your feet flexed, so inhale together, and exhale, gently pull the legs into the chest, let that right elbow press into the thigh, you should feel the stretch along the back of the leg and the glutes. Breath. And exhale, release. Slowly switch sides. Left ankle on top of the right knee, right leg up 90 degrees. Both feet flex. Interlace the fingers behind the right side. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, gently pull. Make sure you're pulling and finding your edge with each exhale. Continue to create space and a little more room for growth. Now. And
the hips, wrists under the shoulders. Going into our cat cow. So inhaling, dropping the belly. Lifting the tailbone. Lifting the chest, squeezing the shoulder blades together. Chin up. And exhaling. Grounding your back. Pressing the ground away from you. Inhaling, dropping the belly. Slow, deep inhales. And slow exhales. Going at your own pace as slowly as possible. Noticing your body. Bringing awareness to your breath. To your body. When you're done, come back to center. Tuck the toes, lift the knees off the ground. Downward dog. Sending the hips up and back. Biceps by the ear. Keep your upper body engaged. Breath is strong. We are upside down. We want to make sure we're circulating oxygen throughout the body. We're going to inhale left leg up. Exhale. Bring it forward. Drop the right knee. Coming into our runner's lunge. Make sure your ankle is under your knee and you can stay supported by letting your shoulder rest on your knee. We're gonna inhale together and exhale. Send the hips forward. This is our supported runner's lunge. You can stay here or you can tuck the toes, lift the knees off the ground. Whatever works best for you, just make sure you're listening to your body, knowing your limits, but also finding yourselves in uncomfortable positions and finding comfort in it. Ready, slowly send the hips back. Coming into your half split, making sure your right ankle is directly under your hip. Left leg is straight or slightly bent. If your leg is straight, you're going to keep your chest lifted as you fold forward. If your leg is straight, you're going to round your back and fold. Keep your hips square, left hip back, right hip forward. Inhale and exhale, fold. Inhale, come back to center. Bring both hands under the face. Shimmy that left foot out just a little bit. And we're just gonna send the hips forward once again, coming into our lizard pose. So make sure that left knee stays close to the body. Our chest is lifted, gaze is forward. Squeeze the shoulder blades together as the hips come closer to the ground. When you're ready, slowly work your way back onto your hands and knees. Swinging hips side to side. Noticing your body, how it's slightly more open on one side than the other. That's okay, that's why we're here. We're here to even things out. But any moment you need to rest, please go ahead and enter your child's pose. Big toes together, knees wide apart, arms forward, forehead on the ground. If not, you can go ahead and rest in downward dog. If you're in child's pose, knee back and downward dog, and when you're ready, inhale the right leg up, bring it forward, drop that left knee, coming into our supported runner's lunge, make sure your ankle is under your knee, shoulder rests on top of that knee, take a deep inhale, and exhale, fold. Lean forward, press the hips closer to the ground. Allow the hips to sink, let it open, create space, create more mobility. You can stay here, or you can tuck your toes, lift your knee off the ground. Send that heel back, or come back on the ground. Slowly work your way onto your half split, finding whether your leg straight or bent is better for you. Find it. Keep your hips square. Remember, if your leg is bent, your back is straight. If your leg is straight, your back is round. Exhale, fold. Slowly release, come back to that lunge, but this time bringing both hands under the face and shimmying that right leg out to the side. Keep that right knee close to the body as you enter your lizard pose. Sending the hips forward, closer to the ground, chest lifted, gaze is forward. When you're done, slowly send your hips back as you come back to tabletop. Check in with yourself. Notice how the body is feeling. Make circles with the hips. Move them side to side. Front to back. Noticing how open we're both will help. Noticing how open both sides are feeling. And then slowly coming back to downward dog or rest in child's pose. taking all the time that you need to rest. Ready, if you're in downward dog, stay here for two more breaths, or if you're in child's pose, come back to downward dog. And this is where we will end our practice with a final hip opening pose. Inhale the left leg up, bring it forward, drop the knee to meet the left hand. Slowly slide that right leg behind you. Coming into our pigeon pose. So naturally your hips, your body's going to want to lean over to the left side. Try to bring that right hip closer to the ground. Keep the hips squared. So this pose we did earlier, but we were on our backs. And all these poses and hip opening poses have led us up to try and at least do this pose. And if you can't, that's okay. We're just slowly working our way into this, okay? So the goal is to hold for about 10 breaths, but if you can only hold for 5, that's okay. Starting upright, and with each passing breath, I personally like to work my way all the way down onto my forearms, and then even sometimes making a pillow with my arms and allowing my head to rest on the ground. Using my body weight to gently open up my hips and create more space. Wherever you are is perfect. Whenever you're ready, slowly work your way up with control onto your hands. Tuck the right toes, lift the knee off the ground as you slowly work your left leg back into tabletop. Moving the hips side to side, front to back, make circles. You can rest in child's pose or meet back in downward dog. When you're ready, right leg comes up. We're doing the same thing on the other side. Lean forward, place your knee on the ground next to your right hand. Starting upright, make sure your hip stays square. Bringing that right hip off the ground. now left hip on the ground. Starting wherever works best for you. Holding the pose for 10 breaths. And if you need to come out of it after 5, that's okay. Meet back in child's pose. Control. When you're ready, slowly rise to center, tuck the left toes, lift the knee off the ground, bring that right leg back into tabletop. Swinging the hips side to side, front to back, make circles, do some cat-cow. Ready. Let's meet on our backs into Shavasana. Extending the legs, allowing the hips to sink as your back is supported by the ground. Hands can stay on our sides or on our belly. To feel the movement of our breath as it enters and exits our lungs. Taking a few deep breaths in and out. Allow your body to relax. To unwind, to clear your mind. Scan your body one more time. Notice any areas where you feel tightness, where you feel resistance, and just let it go. Take a deep breath in through the nostrils. Exhale out the mouth. Slowly bring awareness back to your body. Taking deep breaths by and wiggling your toes and your fingers. Rotating your wrists and your ankles. Bending the elbows. Bending your knees. Slowly reaching up and over your head, pointing your toes. Giving yourself a nice long good morning stretch. Slowly rolling onto your side, keeping your eyes closed as you come to seated. Legs crossed or extended, palms together in prayer, thumb to the heart, slightly bow your head. As always, we take this time to acknowledge ourselves, acknowledge our practice, acknowledge the fact that we took this time to honor our bodies, to give ourselves this time to just be. The light in me honors and acknowledges the light within you. Namaste.